and I am a student at IFP School. My colleagues and I are working on a sustainable development project in petroleum companies. Nowadays, everyone talks about it. In magazines, newspapers, or even in political campaigns. This term covers everything and anything. But do they really know what sustainable development means? During this video, we will see different oil and gas projects contributing to sustainable development. But first, let's start by asking people what they already know about it.
What comes into your mind when you hear sustainable development projects in petroleum companies?
Maybe renewable energies?
Reduce gas emissions?
Selective sorting and recycling?
Really? Is it possible?
Maybe those answers are not surprising to you, as they are the classical ones for this question. But when you think a little bit about this, you realize it's just a little part of what can be done in a sustainable way in oil and gas projects through three main axes: economical, environmental, and social. The idea of training in petroleum companies is to train local population where drilling or operations take place. Take African countries, for example, which are a common location for oil and gas firms. Before, the great majority of workers, operators, technicians, engineers came from Europe and were expatriated for several years. However, now the trend is that industries don't send many people overseas and prefer to hire the population of the country in which the companies make the extraction or the production. That's why companies have invested in ways of training in the form of schools to obtain a qualified labor force. Sustainable development is here expressed through employment creation in developing countries. We'll continue now with the technological improvements in the refinery and how they contribute in sustainable development. TERG integration improves energy efficiency of operation units. It allows to reduce costs and gas emissions. But how does it work? In refineries, for example, products have to be cooled before going to the storage tanks. Classically, we use air cooler to decrease the temperature of products by forcing the circulation of air. The heat energy is released to the atmosphere by airflow. How can we use this lost energy? We can use it, for example, to heat houses. We can use a heat exchanger to recover a part of the heat energy. The general heating network is connected to the refinery exchangers, and this allows to reduce the chimney emissions. Now, let's talk about product improvements as a part of sustainable development. Incorporating new additives in automotive fuel can be one of them. But what is it exactly? It's an organic product which improves the quality and the properties of fuel before its commercialization. There are different additives for each commercial fuel type. Let's see an example on how innovation in additives is beneficial for the environment and your economical savings. Imagine two cars on the same road with the same quantity of fuel. The red car on the left side uses gasoline with classic additives, whereas the yellow one on the right side uses gasoline with special additive. The cars stop. As the cars are moving, the yellow car with the special additive releases less polluting gases. This car can also travel a longer distance with the same amount of fuel. It represents a reduction in CO2 emissions and fuel economies. Shall we continue to talk about new technologies and advanced products? Lubricating oils are a good example of it. The new formulation of lubricants makes them more efficient, which protects and extends the equipment lifetime. In addition, it reduces mechanical energy losses and consequently energy consumption. The lubricant itself has a longer life cycle, reducing its consumption and used oil volumes. Another great improvement is the biodegradable and non-toxic lubricants. Specially developed for farms and crop equipment, these oils allow maximum protection without presenting any risk for the environment in case of leakage. We hope that after seeing these examples, you realize that sustainable development is not limited to the environment protection, but includes economical and social aspects too. The challenge for oil and gas companies now is to keep improving their sustainable projects while answering to a continuous increase in global energy demand.